Welcome to the October Cozy Escape Book Club Choices. The theme for this month is baking, which is my all-time favorite cozy mystery theme, category, trope, whatever you want to call it. If a book has baking in it, I'm 1000% there. Or chocolate. Chocolate or baking, either one, they're totally interchangeable. Those are my favorite. In fact, I looked the other day, there aren't a lot of chocolate books out there. I think there was like one chocolate shop book and then that was kind of it. Because I was thinking like we can maybe make chocolate a theme for next year, but there just aren't enough books. In fact, it is very difficult for Courtney and I to find these books. We scour everywhere to look for things that are still in existence. So we never want to start a new series that has been canceled or discontinued. So it's kind of a challenge. I mean, luckily there are a lot of baking cozy mysteries out there, but because I have five today, it's because three were crossed off the list and two I kept. Now, in the past, sometimes I have suggested books where I feel a little bad and I'm like, I probably could have done a little bit more due diligence, read through some more reviews, or tried to do that, you know, look inside to read the book, because it turned out they were a dud, like that Scottish bookshop mystery. I feel bad. That was my suggestion. It sounded so cool. So I had some books that I was going to suggest, but then after doing a little bit more reading and research, I realized they really weren't the right books for us. So I'm going to go through all of those books for you today. I'm Lisa, author of the Frosted Misfortunes cozy mystery series, starring my own little kitty cat, Lucky. On this channel, we talk all about mysteries, whether those are books, TV shows, or movies. So if this sounds like you or something you might be interested in, make sure to hit the subscribe button below. I post new videos every Tuesday. All right, let's get into today's list. So I'm going to give you the three that were rejected because I was really excited about those. They were on the list first, and then we'll go into the two that I selected. Now, don't forget, Courtney has a video on her channel with her two choices, so make sure to go and watch that over there. So let's get into the first reject book. So the first reject book is Southern Peach Pie and a Dead Guy by Poppy Peters mystery by a gardener. Now, I did a review of this. I did read this. So I don't know if you realize I pick out all of my books for us at the beginning of the year, right as soon as we announce what the categories or themes are for the month. And then I just kind of double check them as we get closer. And this one I thought was going to be amazing, but I read this and I gave it a one, mostly because it's all about anorexia. Like this ex-ballet person is just obsessed with her weight, which I don't even know why you would put a ballerina into a baking school. She's like totally freaked out all the time and drinking thin tea. So I just feel like that sends like a negative message and just makes people feel self-conscious, or maybe it's just me that feels self-conscious about it. So I like crossed that off the list. The second book is Brand New Death by Victoria Hamilton. I actually like this book, but I didn't love it. Like it was a three, but I wouldn't read any more in the series. So I just took that one off the list as well. And I did do a review on that on a prior book wrap up for the month. And then the third one that I took off the list was Murder Most Sweet by Laura Jensen Walker. And this is a bookish baker mystery. And it looked cute. It was like about books and about a bakery, but it's really all about cancer. So the main character talks about cancer. She talks about her breasts. She talks about surviving. And that's a great topic. And I'm not saying we should not support those types of topics, but for me, I never want to read that when I want to read something happy and kind of escape away. And I feel like reading about that particular depressing subject is something that you should do by choice and not as like light, happy reading. So those were the three books that I kind of like X'd out, but they did have cute covers. So I did like think about them for a while, but let's get into the two books that are chosen for today. So the first one is The Sweet Dreams Bake Shop, and this is by J.A. Whiting. It is the first in a Sweet Cove mystery. Now, it does say it has some paranormal elements, like very light, but I didn't really get that from reading the beginning or from the description. It's a woman who owns a bakery and she's about to lose her lease. So she is scrambling around to find a new location. And then at the same time, somebody dies and she gets pinned for the murder. So that is the first book. The next book is Taste Like Murder. This is first in the Cookies and Chance Mysteries by Katherine Bruns. And this is from the Gemma Halliday collection, which usually has a little bit more of a contemporary kind of feel to it. But it does start out with a little bit of a cliche ending. A woman, her ex-husband is cheating on her, so then she moves back home. However, it has a fun twist. She opens up a cookie shop that has fortune cookies. So they have little fortunes in them. I didn't realize you could have a whole store like that, but why not? And inside of there is her ex-husband's girlfriend, or the person that she, like, he cheated on her with, ends up dead on her doorstep. So she has to solve that mystery. And it says that there is a love triangle involved as well. So those are our two choices for the month. Make sure to head over to Courtney's channel, vote on there. And I will leave a direct link on where to vote on Patreon. And we will see you soon. And don't forget, it is absolutely free to join the Cozy Escape Book Club and to follow us on Patreon. There are paid options. Those are totally optional. All book club stuff is still free. So that's that. All right. I hope everyone's having a great weekend, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.